and you should easily be able to get them to 200 plus thousand miles. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we are talking about common problems and reliability issues with GM's LFX engine. The LFX is a 3.6 liter naturally aspirated V6, and it was used in a number of Buick, Cadillac, Chevy, and GMC vehicles from 2012 until 2017. The LFX in all applications produces over 300 horsepower, and so it's actually quite a strong engine coming from a naturally aspirated V6, but the bigger question is the LFX engine reliable? That question becomes a little bit more important because the LFX is the successor to the LLT engine, and the LLT had quite a poor reputation for reliability due to timing chain failures that ultimately could cause complete catastrophic engine failure. So in this video, we're gonna go ahead and talk about common problems with the LFX, but first I'll go ahead and give you guys just a little bit of a sigh of relief because the LFX is actually substantially more reliable than the LLT. There aren't a ton of overarching problems that can lead to serious engine problems when these cars are maintained properly. And that brings us to our first problem with the LFX is excessive oil consumption. The LFX is known to consume about a quart of oil every 2,000 miles, which is quite excessive for any vehicle, but GM says,
don't worry about it. That's just normal on these things.
And so one quart per 2,000 miles, according to GM, is a normal level of oil consumption. But this is important to understand because vehicles that consume a lot of oil obviously need to be frequently topped up on oil. In addition to that, one of the biggest issues from an oil standpoint is the oil life monitoring system that the LFX engine has automatically calculates when an oil change needs to be done. But the readings on that actually go from 8,000 to 12,000 miles. So it doesn't suggest an oil change any earlier than 8,000. And depending on how it detects your oil quality is, it might even let you go 12,000 miles without an oil change. And guys, I know technology is changing. All these manufacturers are pushing back their oil service intervals, but
I'm telling you, one of the best ways to keep your engine reliable is to change the oil every 5,000 miles.
Ultimately, what happens with these LFX engines is you have grandma driving her Cadillac. Her Cadillac has the LFX engine and it's consuming a lot of oil, but poor grandma doesn't know or understand. And so ultimately what happens is she lets it get a little bit low on oil. And that's what can then lead to a lot of serious and significant problems on the LFX. So ultimately, if you're burning a quart of oil every 2,000 miles, by the time it comes up to actually get your oil change done, you might have possibly burned 4 through 6 quarts of oil if you're waiting every 8 to 12,000 miles to do your oil changes. And 4 to 6 quarts is probably like half to 75% of the oil that these engines even use. And so you're gonna be seriously low on oil if you're not topping these things up in between your oil changes. When it comes to oiling related problems, the cam phasers are typically the first thing to face oil starvation once the LFX gets low on oil. Typically that is gonna throw an error code for your camshaft sensor. And it's also gonna lead to a number of other performance related issues. So just a heads up, if you have a camshaft sensor error code on your car, there's a good chance that it's happening because of cam phaser issues, likely due to oil starvation. Moving on to the second problem. The second problem is something that ultimately is caused by these oil related issues, and that is timing chain failure. Timing chain failure itself is not a problem like it was on the LLT engines. That was predominantly because of a design defect. However, on the LFX engines, it's predominantly caused by low oil, which is caused by the oil consumption problems. Timing chain failure is something that can lead to very serious internal engine damage. And so ultimately this is a problem, but it also isn't a problem if we take care of the oil like we mentioned before. My last note here, when it comes to the timing chain problems did still affect the 2012 models. The timing chain from the LLT carried over to the LFX for 2012, but it was redesigned in 2013. And so if you're looking at a vehicle with the LFX engine in it, go ahead and avoid 2012 models and look for 2013 15 plus because they will be significantly more reliable since they don't have the poor timing chain design. That brings us to the third thing on our list. That is oil leaks coming from the timing chain cover. This engine uses a timing chain, not a timing belt. And so the timing chain sits within a cover bolted up to the front of the engine. And in between that, there is a gasket. What tends to happen over time is that gasket wears down and that causes oil to leak from the front timing chain cover. Ultimately, this is going to lead to even lower oil levels, and you're also going to potentially lose compression from it as well. Fortunately, gaskets aren't super expensive parts. They do require a little bit more in labor just to get to them, access them, and replace them. So ultimately, you need to be aware that oil leaks might occur from the timing chain cover. So if you notice any spots of oil on the ground after you back out of a parking spot, go ahead and have it looked at and check in that location. Those are the three primary issues with the LFX. The fourth one that I have on my list here is water pump failure. Water pumps are somewhat of a maintenance item, but on the LFX engine, they are known to fail a little bit more frequently than you would see on other engines. Typically on these LFX engines, we see them failing somewhere around the 100,000 mile mark. And so if you're above 100,000 miles on your water pump, there's a decent chance that it might go out. But at the same time, there are plenty of them that last 200 plus thousand miles. So that covers it for our list of problems here. At the end of the day, the first three kind of sound scary, but a lot of it really has to do with proper maintenance. As long as we don't have any oil related issues, make sure you've got enough oil in the engine, you don't have any oil leaks coming from the front timing cover, you don't have to worry about any of these problems. It's just really important to know that these engines take a little bit more specialized care and maintenance. So anyways, guys, yes, these LFX engines are reliable. You just need to take care of the oiling situation in them, and you should easily be able to get them to 200 plus thousand miles. That covers it for our guide on problems and reliability of GM's LFX engine. If you guys appreciate this content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future content we have coming.